My name is Bill Wolfgang. I'm the Senior Director of Vehicle Engineering for the MBTA. We are at City Hall Plaza and we have the Type 10 mockup here on display. The Type 10 is our next generation of green line vehicles that will replace our legacy fleets. In 2023, we invited the public to choose the exterior look of the vehicle, and this is the winning version. The mockup will be on display on October 29th and 30th. From 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. The biggest feature that everybody will see is that it's 100% low floor. You'll see our dynamic signs. We have that next stop information, escalator, elevator, all the important information of where the vehicle is in station and what the next station is. 100% low floor allows us to, in the future, go to level boarding. The vehicles are equipped with accessible bridge plates at all the double doors. The bridge plate is an ADA compliant bridge plate that will allow passengers that use mobile devices to enter the vehicle. So the Type 10 will have a 50% increase in rider capacity over the legacy fleet. The added capacity means to our riders that after those long Celtics games and Red Sox games, that they'll have the ability to get on a car quicker and get to their destination quicker. The Type 10 will utilize service-proven technology that we utilized on the Type 9. That way we're not inventing new equipment, and reliability will be increased, and our riding public will see a dramatic improvement in reliability of the vehicle. So based on the current schedule, the first four pilot vehicles will be delivered in 2026. They'll go through a pilot testing phase, which is roughly a year long. And the first production vehicles, which are the first completed vehicles that are ready to roll into passenger service, will be delivered in 2027. And we'll wrap this up with 102 cars later in 2031. The intention of this mockup is to get the public's reaction to the design. We have a window of opportunity, and we will take any comments and feedback that may improve the design. I would like to thank the members of the Vehicle Engineering Department, led by Director of Vehicle Engineering Mark DeVito and Acting Deputy Director Nicole Mason, who have brought this to reality.